grow. Hey, welcome back, Design Squad, and welcome to another Tuesday and another edition of Design Tool Tuesday, where I share the tools which I would usually share with, let's say, my colleagues, peers, junior designers, anyone I know who would benefit from knowing something or using something or new techniques or books or, you know, everything in between, anything that could be classified as a helpful tool or something which gives you a boost in your process or things you want to achieve. And so today we have another tool which is called Laws of UX. And it's because it's a really nicely tailored and really nicely presented laws of UX and its maxims and rules which we live by and which we make every decision when it comes to, let's say, crafting different interfaces which are your, you know, human and user-centered, when we try to achieve some sort of balance in how we lay out the key distinctive areas of, let's say, customer facing type of solutions. And so Laws of UX is basically a collection of 20 different rules. So I'm gonna pick the random one. For example, Hicks Law or Fitts Law are some of the key things which you're gonna encounter when designing bits, and especially if you learn from other designers, they're always gonna mention this as one of the go-to maxims, for example. And Fitts Law is basically describes on a basic terms, no user is expecting to travel far from where they initiate the action. So let's say if you have a button and you click on it and your error message appears somewhere outside in a corner, that probably would break the Fitts Law because the user would, you know, their area of and field and travel time and the proximity of the actual error message would matter a lot because they would expect it to appear near the button, so we know that they initiated that action and that it has a strong connection. So that's the basics of it. And as you can see in the overview of this law, it describes the time to acquire a target is a function of the distance and size of a target. And that's exactly that. So for example, if it takes you a lot of time to distinguish which parts of the interface you have to travel to, you can make it bigger, you can make it closer to the start of your journey. And in that case, you would utilize the Fitts Law. And as you can see, it's simply done and simply explained. There is also mentioned of the origins and the history of it, kind of like a pepper. So if you wanted to find out more, of course, you can go through the source. For example, Jacob's Law, which is like probably one of the most recent laws from Jacob Nielsen. It's basically covering the consistency across the fields and that people expect certain bits and patterns behave like most of them do, because, you know, if you spend years knowing that the main menu behaves like that, you would expect the future main menus behave like that. And there's a lot of to do with, let's say, Lindy effect of different non-perishable concepts which basically remain for years to come and what people expect to do. And so that's the one. There's a lot of different gold nuggets here, and if you go bit by bit, you're gonna get a lot of mention of, let's say, Gestalt laws of psychology, where you have a lot of different perception based and behavior based themes which basically allow you to then think of how you could adapt it to into your designs. Best bit is, as you can see, there is a button download poster. So this tool allows you to download the PDFs of every and each of these laws, and it has a quick mention of what the law actually means. It has a visual representation so you can visually memorize exactly what it is and how it affects, you know, different bits and how you can apply it in UX. And so back in the day in my home office, I had printed them all out and had them framed in a wall to basically make a grid of different bits. Whenever I designed something, I could just refer to it or just have it like, you know, nicely done posters which are minimal. I recommend it always to juniors to check out, but also to teams who want to liven up their spaces where they do, you know, the best work they can. And so that we have a representation of what the team does, because it also attracts the eye of the outsiders. And so you can definitely print those out as posters and use them freely, because this is exactly the reason why this tool exists. And so I hope it's useful. Check it out, check every single one of these, note them down, download the posters, give a thumbs up to the offer, give a thumbs up to this video, subscribe to this channel, and I'll see you next time.